So, according to Surah 33 verse 40, Muhammad is not father to anyone.
No.
And also Muhammad is the seal of the Prophet. Sister, is it correct? In context of the verse is, really Muhammad is about to get married with the wife of his adopted son. That's the context that reason Muhammad
very
is...
sad. Yeah. Very sad.
So, we've got a seal of Prophet who thinks it's alright to get married your wife of your adopted son.
But Hatun, hold on. So this was his adopted son, his son.
Wife of his adopted son.
Who was the one who decided that he should marry the wife of the adopted son?
Allah.
Allah.
So Allah stepped in and Allah helped out to Muhammad and said, dear Muhammad, get married with Zainab.
So why would Allah break up a marriage?
Because context of the verse is, Muhammad wants to visit his adopted son Zaid, and as Muhammad goes to Zaid's house, Muhammad sees Zainab almost half naked.
The wife was almost half naked, not properly dressed.
Yes, and suddenly, seal of the Prophet has lustful feelings. He cannot control himself, and he sees Zainab half naked. What happened to Zaid? Zaid wants to divorce his wife for the sake of Muhammad.
Okay, so that's wrong on so many different levels.
So, and Muhammad thinks, Allah says to Muhammad, Muhammad, you can get married with Zainab. We read this verse in again Surah 33.
Yeah.
According to Sahih Bukhari, seal was the mole in your shoulder, on your shoulder. So it wasn't a sign. It didn't mean he is going to be the last prophet. So they interpreted this Isaiah 9 verse 6, which talks about Jesus and tells us government will be on his shoulders.
Yes.
That's the Muslim interprets that as seal of the Prophet means a mole on your shoulder.
They're talking about two completely different things. When it talks about the government would be on his shoulders, it's talking about power and authority, not some physical mole. Yeah, why would they do that?
Okay, so are you Muslim?
Yes.
Can you help us to understand?
I don't believe of Al-Bukhari.
Okay, tell us.
That the Prophet came as an example.
Yes.
And that is forbidden.
Muhammad came in as an example. And example is, get married with your daughter-in-law.
We married her to you in order that then not be upon the believers any discomfort, ugly guilt. This is what it says concerning the wives of their claims, i.e. adopted son, that they no longer have need of them. What does it mean when you no longer have need of your wife? What does that mean?
You marry you and your adopted son. You
and
your adopted son.
You no longer have need of your wife.
You can now marry
her.
Before it wasn't permissible.
What is the use of a wife that you no longer have need of?
She was married to Zayd, and then Muhammad, he is the best example to mankind, tells he is going to get married with his daughter-in-law. That is disgusting. That is disgusting. Clearly, Muhammad says, it's alright, I can get married with my cousin, it's alright, I can get married with my wife of my adopted daughter. You told us Zainab was the cousin of Muhammad.
I am doing the same thing, what do you do?
Sir,
show me that she is a cousin of Muhammad in the Quran.
I am taking your tradition right now.
You believe in my story. So
no, I don't believe.
Why are you saying it?
I don't believe Islam is true, but I am telling you
choosing.
For
you're
the sake of argument,
story,
I am taking tradition is correct. So far, we looked at the Muhammad in the Quran and let me see. Muhammad thinks it's alright that he can get married with the cousin.
Yeah.
Muhammad thinks it's alright. they can get married with wife of his adopted son.
Right. Not you.
Your daughter-in-law, they were the people who you see as part of your family.
Not your son.
Suddenly, your father is telling you, divorce your wife and I want to get married with that wife. That is just disgusting. What? That is just disgusting.
Hang on.
Let's look at also, Muhammad's habits. Muhammad's habits regarding his wives and his sex slaves. So, according to Surah 66, verse 1 to 2, Muhammad said, breaks the promise, he gave it sake of himself. Okay? Can we look at the Surah 66, verse 1 to 2? Hold on a minute. I'm not talking about the Bible.
No.
Right now, I am talking about, I follow Lord Jesus Christ. Today, I am asking the questions about Muhammad, and I am asking the questions from the Quran, from your holy book, about your holy and perfect prophet. So far, he's been very disgusting prophet. But let's look at the Surah 66, verse 1 and 2. It is disgusting.
You think that he married
Doctor
Sun's wife?
Is there anyone in the crowd thinks it is not disgusting? A prophet, example to mankind, gets married with his wife of his adopted son. Anyone thinks that's a good thing? No one thinks that's a good thing, sir. Maybe only you who thinks that's a good thing. That's disgusting thing.
He's been watching.
Your question. There is nowhere in the Bible. The Bible tells us we need to follow Judah. There is nowhere in the Bible. Bible tells us we need to follow Lot. They were sinful human beings. Bible tells us we need to follow Jesus. Jesus himself says, come and follow me. So, Muhammad tells,
he says, why are you prohibiting from yourself what Allah has made lawful? So it's Allah the one who made it lawful.
So Allah says to Muhammad, if it's lawful, scenario is like this. Because Hafsa is not in the house and Muhammad needs to have sex with someone, slave girl is there and Muhammad goes and have sex with slave girl, and then Allah says, well done. Allah says, well done. Allah does not condemn that.
Well, it's worse than that. He says, why are you seeking the approval from your wife? So don't worry what your wife thinks. And he says, I have already ordained for you the dissolution of your oaths. Now, this is terrible. What does that mean? The dissolution of your oaths.
A prophet who is example to mankind, he is the perfect example. Allah says, it's alright. Allah says, you can break your promises. Why are you obeying and trying to please your wife versus you needed to please Allah? And pleasing Allah in this context is go and continue to sleep with continue to have sex with the slave girl.
And there was a threat, wasn't there?
Yeah, Allah is going to curse
Allah, Gabriel, the righteous of the believers, the angels, and all his assistants are going to curse the women unless they get on board.
So, Allah, angels, righteous of believers, is going to curse the wives if they become disobedient to Muhammad or they attack Muhammad because Muhammad slept with someone else. Another disgusting and disaster thing is happening with Muhammad in the Quran.